For the past 3 months, Federisa, a resident of Moko village in Wezuwera sub-county, has been living a nomadic life. At 60 years, she never gets tired of trekking up and down in search for justice for her 14-year-old daughter, sexually abused by an old man. Together with the victim, who has a 3-month-old baby, she accuses one Mugasha, her immediate neighbor, of infecting her with HIV. Federisa, whom I intercepted on her way to this village community meeting, claims authorities haven't done much to arrest the perpetrator.
RDC akangira ngo umushango ya garo wa Cheyman ati Cheyman ashakuyashikire twazo mukote bwire buyakubire na reba nko muntu ato mushango guno gwamani yampereze biro byahari na nyaho ntombire ningira ntapana deka ngaro nzaha police.
The victim, identity concealed, lost both parents, and it's the helpless grandmother taking care of her. The victim, that we shall call Ainimbabazi for this report, narrates how she succumbed to petty gifts from Mugasha. Unfortunately, this girl child turned mother has become a village laughingstock, which affects her psychological well-being. Besides, she is undergoing a tough experience of accessing antiretroviral drugs and also breastfeeding a baby. All this is happening when the perpetrator is merely roaming in the village in the eyes of authorities and police mandated to protect the girl child.
They are being done and they are not being reported. So we encourage the communities through sensitizations to report these cases. And where cases have been reported and taken note of as police, the perpetrators have been really taken note of for them to face the law as usual. And of course, their punishments are not simple.
Ever since, over 15 million children were sent home after schools closed to mitigate effects of COVID-19, police reported a cocktail of over 21,000 cases of child abuse. This literally means that averagely, on a monthly basis, at least 4,200 cases are registered.
I would advise that the parent is the first teacher. And if you are the first teacher, the civil society, which is RHU, all the schools come in to substitute on what the parent has done. Because if we rush for family planning services or methods, we are not solving the problem. We are just helping, responding to the issue. But are we preventing it?
Article 123 of the Penal Code Act states that such acts lay down death sentence if proved guilty by courts of law. However, police have admitted that prosecuting a sexual violence case is an uphill task for them.
Personally, as a liaison's officer, I'm not aware of that case, and I think the supervisors in the police of Ruiz are not aware of that case. And let me also tell you and warn people that It is very true that some other people concoct these cases. Where people have issues of land matters, or they have conflicts, they bring in these matters. They even go to doctors and concoct some medical reports, which is not true. So I also urge people not to concoct cases which are not done.
As a result, relatives to victims prefer to report to their respective village heads, and this has seen local courts assuming the roles of the higher courts. A few years ago, Barra Central Police rescued this 64-year-old man from angry mob in Kakoba, Barra City, of allegations of raping a 4-year-old girl. This, according to experts, points to the fact that the population has lost trust in authorities, whom they think will always free suspects accused of capital offences.
We are expressing the level of the problem in terms of the experiences of the community. So in this community, they experience violence of children, school dropout, the violence. For example, when we were conducting our baseline survey, we found here a number of adverse effects. We found a case of a grandfather who was sleeping with a grandchild whom they were staying with. Children who are being married off when they were still young. This community is not far away from the challenges of sexual and reproductive health related risks.
Before COVID-19 pandemic, Uganda had 1.6 million children living with HIV, according to UNICEF, adding that there is a likelihood of an increase attributed to prolonged COVID-19 lockdown.
In Uganda, we have what we call a reverse pyramid. The young age groups are much more than the older ones. Almost more than 50% of the population is below 18 years. So when we look at the effects of COVID, if we are to do a census tomorrow, our pyramid will be broader, the base is broader with young people. So for the question for the planners is to look into this budding population. More young people every day, increasing the burden of those who are working and they have to look after the young people.
For decades, Demographics and Health Survey has put the annual growth around 3.2 and fertility rates at 4.7% births per woman. The truth is, though, unreported cases of sexual exploitation in the lockdown have peaked. As a result, calls to resort to contraceptives amongst adolescents have been loud, with minimal attention from line ministries.
Currently, the effects of pregnancy, we are seeing it on the girl child. They will get out of school, they will have children which they can't care for. Their families will abandon them and chase them away from homes. Boys who have made them pregnant will run away from them. So the effects, we see a lot of burden. Instead of saying that we must protect our values of knowing that children are not having sex and we bury our heads in the sand, we would rather give them information so that in case they're having sex, they prevent themselves.
We should promote uptake of family planning. Promote it at all levels to ensure that if someone got pregnant today, they would spend more time before they get another child. And those who are not yet pregnant shouldn't get pregnant when they are not ready. So an action should be taken in terms of economic development as well as the health of these young people.
Surprisingly, the Minister of Gender has severally confessed to the fact that most homes have become unsafe places for children due to poor parenting roles. This suggests all hopes remain towards reopening of schools next year, but as to whether most girls will be able to return, time will tell. Report by Halson Kagure for the news.